Hey guys, how's everyone doing? I'm Anime Intensity and welcome back to my channel. So today we're having another episode of Anime News, which I haven't done in a couple of weeks, but that's just because the past couple of weeks have been kind of quiet. Not too much going on in the industry, but this week I feel like there have been several announcements that we have to talk about, and that's why we are having Anime News today. So I hope you guys enjoy this video and let's get started. First thing that we're going to be discussing today is something that made me facepalm and ask myself, why is this happening? So, let's just get this over with. Pokemon is actually getting a live action. That's right. The film studio Legendary has actually acquired the rights to make a Pokemon live action film. I don't really know how this is going to turn out because we know how video game adaptations turn out when it goes to Hollywood. So, I don't really know how it's going to be adapted. I'm very unsure and I don't know why this is happening. So, this announcement was actually made right after Pokemon Go was released, and as we know, Pokemon Go has received widespread success, over 30 million users. So I could see why film companies would want to acquire the rights for Pokemon, because with this popularity, imagine making a movie and making even more money. Like, so I could see why film companies would want to make a Pokemon movie. I just don't know how it's going to be done or if it's going to be good, and I'm just very, very scared. This Pokemon film is actually going to focus around Detective Pikachu. If you didn't know, there's going to be a game about Detective Pikachu. It hasn't been released yet, but it's going to be about Detective Pikachu, to solve mysteries, whatever, whatever. I don't know too much about it, but I just don't know if making a movie, a live action, off of a one game about Detective Pikachu is really the smartest idea. It might be different and it might work because of that, but I'm just not very sure. So I don't know why they're doing this, but who knows? Maybe it'll be good. So yeah, I just had to get that off my chest. It was upsetting me. Moving on to some good news. It turns out there's going to be free streaming of the Mobile Suit Gundam movies, the trilogy, like the first three movies. So we have like Mobile Suit Gundam 1, then you have 2, Soldiers of Sorrow, and number 3, which is Encounters in Space. So on Sunrise's Gundam Portal on YouTube, they will be streaming these three movies for free from July 22nd to September 1st. You have a big window to go check out these movies if you're a Gundam fan. It's a great opportunity, free opportunity, to watch the first three movies in the Gundam franchise. These three movies are basically a retelling of the original series, so it's a very good way to catch up with the Gundam series. Like, if you haven't watched the original series, now you can watch those three films and basically get a gist of what that series went through and what happened. So I do think that's a great thing, especially for free. Everything will be in the original Japanese language with English subtitles. So go check that out if you're a Gundam fan. I think that's great. So now for the news that actually kind of confused me this week. It turns out that Viz Media has actually announced a partnership with Tubi TV, which will now be streaming free anime. So free anime, that always sounds good. Free anime, yes. That's a great thing, having free anime that can be watched, you know, on various platforms, whatever, whatever. This announcement was very confusing to me because I have never even heard of Tubi TV. I was like, Tubi TV, what on earth is that? I've never heard of Tubi TV. So when I saw this announcement, I didn't know what to expect. I was like, is this a good thing? Is this a bad thing? I mean, it's probably a good thing because it's gonna be free anime, but I don't know too much about Tubi TV at all, so it's kind of scary. I don't know what to expect, basically. And basically, anime will be streamed for free in North America, which includes Canada. They're gonna have series like Death Note, Naruto, Sailor Moon, and Sailor Moon Crystal, and those series will be up to completion on Tubi TV. You'll be able to watch them there for free, and that's also just a very good way to spread anime. I think that's a great idea to have another platform to stream anime from, especially for free. But my concern is, like, how is the quality going to be? How often is this site going to be crashing? You know, if it's totally free, is it going to be high definition? Is it going to be moving slow and refreshing all the time? Are there going to be a lot of ads? I don't know. So I'm just kind of unsure about this partnership. I hope it goes well. I love free anime, and I think that's great for the industry to put up, you know, free anime, free legal anime for everyone to watch. So I think it's a cool thing, but I'm just unsure of how it's going to turn out, because like I said, I don't even know anything about Tubi TV. If you ever use Tubi TV, let me know. All the anime that are going to be distributed are going to be in the original Japanese language and with English subtitles. Those four series that I said earlier are just some of the series that are going to be on Tubi TV. They haven't announced any other series, but they are going to add more titles eventually, so that's pretty cool. Next up, it turns out that Toonami is actually adding another anime to their broadcast time. It turns out that Toonami is going to be airing airing JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. That's right, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure will now be airing on Toonami starting in October. They haven't really specified a date yet, but just knowing that they're going to be adding JoJo's Bizarre Adventure is enough to create hype. Like, that's crazy. That's great. That's great news. You know, Toonami's been doing a great job, you know, picking the anime that they've decided to show. I mean, we had Gundam, Iron-Blooded Orphans, One Punch Man, then we're getting JoJo's Bizarre Adventure on Toonami. That is great news. I mean, we have to wait until October, but I think that's such a great anime to pick. It's so popular, and it's going to be starting with Phantom Blood, so if you haven't watched JoJo's Bizarre Adventure at all, well, now you'll be able to watch it on Toonami, and so long as you have Toonami, given that and Cartoon Network, but I think it's a great anime to pick from, and I think it's great news. Next up, I know this news isn't exactly anime-related, but it turns out that Nintendo will be releasing a miniature NES, and it looks so cute, and I remember seeing this announcement, and I was like, this isn't real, no way. So I was kind of, like, in shock when I saw that, because I didn't think that Nintendo would do that, and to see them bring back the NES in a way is totally, totally cool. So, great announcement. There's going to be 30 pre-installed classic games like Metroid, Ice Climbers, Excitebike, Castlevania, Legend of Zelda, and more on this mini NES. For those of you who haven't had an NES, well, now you have an opportunity to get one. I mean, I know it's just like 8-bit graphics, but there's such wonderful games for the NES, and I've always wanted to play a lot of these games. So, to have that opportunity is just extraordinary, and I know a lot of fans are very happy to see the NES kind of be released again. It's small and cute, and it's going to be released on November 11th. It's going to be at a retail price of $60, and it's going to include the HDMI cable, AC adapter, and I believe the controllers are separate at $10. So that's going to be really awesome, and I can't wait. Personally, when I saw this announcement, I was like, ooh, I think it's great. I think it's great. Now it turns out that one of the big three manga is actually coming to an end. That's right, Bleach is actually going to be ending in 10 chapters. Tite Kubo actually announced in a quote that was actually kind of like in riddle. He said, "The time draws near when all stories come to their end, just X more chapters." So when I saw this announcement, I was like, oh, okay, so X meaning 10. So I was like, okay, there's only gonna be 10 more chapters? Like, what's going on? And then after like some clarification, the Global Shonen Jump podcast, yes, it is clear that Bleach is actually going to be ending in 10 more chapters, which is crazy because Bleach already has, you know, 73 volumes. So it's gonna be concluding with a 74th volume, but that's such a very, very long running series, and to see it finally end, sometimes it just feels, it's sad to see such long series come to an end. I know Bleach has definitely had its high moments and low moments, but you know, Bleach I really did enjoy at certain points, so you know, it's sad to see it have to go, but all stories must come to an end, so sad about that. But on the other hand, it turns out that One Piece, after 82 volumes, is actually only 65% complete. 65 with 82 volumes already. Now that is a long-running series. I don't know when this manga is going to end, or if it will end, because 65% complete, 82, oh wow. That's crazy. That is absolutely crazy. So One Piece is definitely not ending anytime soon. So that's great news for all of you One Piece fans, but I'm just like wondering, like, wow. Wow, that takes some dedication and commitment to stick to your own project for more than 82 volumes. That takes a lot of work. So I give the guy credit because that's a lot of drawing to do. With Bleach ending and some other series ending, it turns out that Shonen Jump will be debuting three new series, and we don't really know too much about these three new series. There's not really like a plot or anything too much known about them, but we do know the titles. These three mangas will be debuting like every week, so one every week. So they're actually going to be titled Yakusoku Neverland, which is probably going to have amazing art just because the artist who's working on this manga has actually really beautiful illustrations. He's on Twitter, so check him out because his illustrations are gorgeous. So that's something that I'm looking forward to, Yakusoku Neverland. We're also going to be releasing Love Rush and Red Strike, which once again, we don't know too much about them, but very interesting to have new series debuting. So keep your eyes peeled for these new manga series debuting over the next couple of weeks in Shonen Jump, because maybe you're going to have a new favorite soon. So that's pretty cool. Last but not least, I wanted to end this video on a high note. Just some chuckles and laughs. It turns out that a bunch of people in Central Park in New York City have actually like created created a stampede because they thought that they saw a Vaporeon in Central Park, and here's the video, and it's just, it's crazy to see thousands of people in Central Park go crazy over a Vaporeon. Like, did we ever expect this kind of thing to happen? Like, this is so, so interesting to see, and I love crazy stories about Pokemon Go. So if you have your own crazy stories of Pokemon Go, make sure you comment below, tell me your crazy stories, because I might be making a video of it sometime soon if I get enough crazy stories, you know, I don't know. It sounds kind of fun, so if you would like to submit, you know, your own story about Pokemon Go, make sure you just comment below, and maybe you'll see in an upcoming video. So yeah, that's very exciting. So I hope you guys enjoyed this week's anime news. Thanks for watching. I totally appreciate it. Please like, share, subscribe if you liked this video. Oh, and make sure you check out my Twitter for updates, video updates, whatever, just to follow me, whatever you want to do. I have a Twitter, I have an Instagram, I have Facebook, which needs more likes, so go give it a thumbs up. So check out those links. They're always going to be in the description box below. Once again, thank you guys so much, and I will see you guys next time. It's like they complement each other so well, because you have like this crazy personality who's so exuberant and so outgoing and creative and curious and everything, and then we have this reserve